All right, guys, welcome back to another episode of Backcountry Brothers. We're here today in Great Sand Dunes National Park. We're actually going to be doing some backcountry hiking today. Our plan for this adventure is to do the two highest dunes in the park, which are the two highest dunes in North America, and that's Star Dune and Hidden Dune. We also brought along this bad boy on my back, a little sandboard, so we're going to be breaking that out. Definitely going to be a few miles. I think we're looking at about 11 miles round trip, so looking forward to a good adventure. So we're approaching Star Dune, and we can kind of see the route we're gonna take. It kind of leads right up through this grassy valley, kind of in between the ridges of the dunes. And we're hoping that that kind of mitigates the steepness of some of these, because they're pretty tough walking. Thousands of years, how many miles have we wandered under the sky, chasing our fear? Some kind of trouble is coming, don't know when. So I don't think we're gonna hit Star Dune before sunset. I think it's gonna be a little dark. This slog is taking forever. It's just pretty tough walking. Fortunately, one of the things I'm most looking forward to tonight is the stars. We'll have some great star visibility. There's not a ton of clouds at all, and I think it'll clear up even more overnight. I will stand by you, brother. So we got good news and bad news. Good news, we made it to the campsite. Good news, we'll get to eat our peanut butter and jellies. And good news, we'll be able to dump the sand out of our shoes. Bad news is we didn't make it to Star Dune and it's really dark. So it took way longer than we thought. But yeah, we're gonna set up tent here. Hopefully we don't blow away in the night.
It's gonna blow away. Oh.
All right, so it's day two of our backpacking adventure in Great Sand Dunes. We had a pretty cool night. The stars were definitely out, and we ended up hiking to Star Dune, which was pretty incredible just to kind of be out here by ourselves and take in the views. It's something that really doesn't translate through a camera. You kind of just got to come out here and do it yourself. Right now I got Josh kind of taking the tent apart. I think we're gonna try to head on over to Hidden Dune, maybe do some sandboarding today. Another beautiful day it looks like, hardly a cloud in the sky.
Watch this technique. On the wrist.
So Josh is gonna do the devil's hole run. Pretty steep, but we'll see how he does.
So far, so good. If I have to do this all the way to the bottom, it's gonna be a long way. Oh, here we go. Picking up some momentum. Woo!
So Mitchell is climbing up to do his first run, and he was pretty confident in himself. I got a feeling he's gonna fall. Pretty confident in that, but we'll see how it goes.
I got the utmost confidence in you, Mitchell.
I believe
you can make it all the way.
Let's try that again.
Oh. All right, here we go.
Dude, this is impossible. Holy crap. Holy moly.
All right, we're here with Mitchell here after his first run here, and he's gonna give us his thoughts.
I think I killed it. And by killed it, I mean almost killed me. and I lost my phone. So that is not how to do the first run. That was way more speed than I was expecting.
So we are on round two of Sandboard Olympics with Mitchel. Oh.
So fast. Look at that view. So, baby.
So we are on top of Star Dune right now, and we're gonna head over to Hidden Dune, which is somewhere in that area over there. But first we're gonna have Mitchel, I think he's gonna slide down Star Dune here.
Sandboarding the highest dune in North America. I might take my glasses off for this. Let's roll.
Oh, shit.
That was a fail.
Oh yeah, there we go. This is the money. You got it! Go, 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 go!
That was violent. I am covered in sand. They don't tell you how bad the sand hurts when you're going like 20 miles an hour and just wipe out completely.
Nailed it.
So we're still meandering our way over to Hidden Dune, which is right behind us here, and probably a little over halfway, I'd say, from Star Dune. But long, tough slog. We're gonna keep pushing it and should make it there hopefully within an hour or so, but we'll see.
Boom! Summit!
Oh, dude, what a workout.
Top of Hidden Dune. I'll do a 360 here. Holy moly. This was a tough hike.
So we're on top of Hidden Dune right now, and we're about 10 miles deep, probably 2 to 3 more to get out to High Dune and eventually to the parking lot. Looking forward to that. Bit of a slog, but we're gonna enjoy this nice, gentle ride down here where I'm gonna shred some sand and hopefully make it down in one piece, but you know, we'll give it a shot.
Here you go.
Oh my. Holy.
Oh my god.
He survived. That looks so fast.
Go, go, go.
Alright, we just made it to the top of High Dune. Super windy up here. We survived the long, tough haul. You can see the parking lot in the distance behind me. Overall, great hike, tough hike, hot hike, sandy hike.
There it goes.
You've been gone for a long, long time. You've been no wind. You've been on my mind. You are the purest soul.
Just got back to the parking lot. We did about 11 miles, about 3,000 feet of vert, but when you're doing it on sand, it feels like a lot more. Hit up Star Dune, Hidden Dune, and then High Dune as well at the end of the day, and did some boarding down all of them, so that was pretty cool. Last night was spectacular with the stars, but overall, it's been a pretty good day. I think we're gonna wrap things up here and head on our way for the next adventure with Backcountry Brothers.